Okay, thank you, and welcome to the sixth meeting of 2023 in session six of the Equalities, Human Rights and Civil Justice Committee. We have one public item on our agenda this morning. That's consideration of the continued petition PE1787 on the use of Makaton Sign Language in the legal system, and I refer members to paper one. Members will recall that we took evidence from the petitioner, Sandra Docherty, at our meeting on the 13th of December last year, after which we agreed for the clerks to write to Scottish Government officials for their initial thoughts on the evidence. And the clerk's note summarises the Scottish Government response, which is included as an annex to the paper. It notes that the Scottish Government highlights a range of measures that enable the provision of communication support within the legal system, and suggests that perhaps a wider range of support is needed than Makaton alone can provide. Members will recall during the evidence session that we discussed whether there was any data on the number of Makaton users and support providers. Scottish Government response points us towards the Public Guardian in Scotland and the Mental Wealth Care Commission for Scotland, who might hold that relevant information. Clark's note also provides the option of us writing to the Scottish Courts and Tribunal Service and Police Scotland to establish whether they have any records in this area. Scottish Government also draws attention to recommendation 5.1 of the recent report by the Scottish Mental Health Law Review and offers to keep the committee updated in relation to its response to that recommendation. So I think it's a relatively healthy, helpful response from the Scottish Government, but it's obviously now for us to decide how we feel we'd want to take this forward or indeed close the petition. Karen Adam, do you want to come in first?
Yes, thank you, convener. First off, I've got to say I'm so grateful to Sandra, for the petitioner, for bringing this to committee. I think she's done an exceptional amount of work to get it this far. I think what she's also done is widened the conversation around Makaton. It's brought it into a lot of people's awareness, elected representatives specifically. The only concern I would have in regard to this petition is that I feel that the scope of it is so narrow, and I feel that it would limit the potential of what we could actually do in regards to Makaton in the Equalities Committee. I would like to do a broader piece of work, and I'm not quite sure if we can do that with this.
Okay, I think the committee could take a decision to broaden the scope of our work, which has been inspired by this petition for sure. Maggie Chapman.
Thanks very much, Joe. I think I agree with the sentiment Karen expressed there. I think we've, with this petition, we've been able to consider Makaton and some other issues that maybe we haven't before. And I think for me, thinking specifically about this petition, I know if you know, we could close it, we could keep it open, we could widen work. My concern with closing it just now, as it stands, is I'm not sure that closes the loop for the petitioner, for Sandra herself. And I think we know that we've sent her the Scottish Government's response, but I think it would be, I would like to give her the opportunity to come back to us with any final comments. I also think there's something about that wider work that Karen talks about, because the balance that we've got in the papers, the balance between accessibility and just judicial rigour, I think is really, really quite important. And it's quite a narrow line, I think, in some ways. But I'd like to see us explore, not only injustice, but in other areas as well, how we can actually bring Makaton much more into our understanding of accessible communication. And what are then the knock-on consequences for the public services that we rely on. So yeah, I think I'd like us to keep the petition open for now, to give Sandra an opportunity to come back to us, but also to say, actually, you know, we do see this as kicking off a wider body of work, and we can then, you know, over the coming weeks, months, however long it takes, see how we take that forward.
Okay, thank you. And Fulton McGregor, please.
Yeah, Thanks very much, convener. I wanted to just say that I'd agree completely with what Karen, Adam and Maggie Chapman have said. I think that, you know, at this point, I do think that ultimately we need to be closing off this petition, but we need to keep Sandra involved in that loop, and let her know exactly what we're thinking about it. So more work to be done, I think, would be ideal, and give us time to sort of develop what that work might look like, get it to Sandra and others. Other stakeholders for their feedback on it, and then progress it forward. Just like others as well, I want to put on record my thanks to Sandra. I think when she came in front of the committee, she was absolutely fantastic, and her passion for this area, is there for all to see. And I think that we need to have that on record. And she's done a really good thing by bringing this into the public domain and giving us the initiative, if you like, to take it further and to make lives better for people. So my thanks to Sandra as well. Not overly comfortable with closing it today, but I do think we need to get to that point. Probably a wee bit more work we need to do just to get there, though.
Okay, thanks, Fulton. Pam Duncan-Glancy.
Thank you, convener. I would just like to also put on record my thanks to the petitioner for drawing this to the attention of not just the committee, but other committees and indeed the Parliament. I think it's a really important issue that they've brought up. I'm particularly concerned about the fact that the issues raised around people who had been victims of crime or perhaps witnesses and felt unable to represent what they'd seen or experienced because of a lack of support, perhaps to use or to communicate in a way that they need to. So I think it's really important that we do that bit extra work on it before we close this petition. I'm really keen that we explore a little bit further what the Courts and Tribunal Service are doing, what Police Scotland's understanding is, and also what local authorities are doing around the use of an appropriate adult in situations where the person needs support to communicate to the police. So once we've established those lines of communication and sort of let that work continue, then I think we would be in a position to say sort of we've done that and we're now in a position to close it. But as yet, I feel like we need to just do that little bit extra work and then we'll get there. But again, I'd like to say thanks very much to the petitioner.
Okay, thank you. Rachel or Pam, are you? Rachel Hamilton.
So most of my fellow committee members have covered what I was going to cover. Thank you to the petitioner in particular. I don't support closing the petition at this stage, but I do support exploring other avenues that are wider than has been set out by the petitioner.
Okay. Pam Gussell.
I'd have to agree with Rachel and everything else that's been said, and obviously put on record thanking the petitioner as well. I don't know if this was mentioned. I had put down to write to the Public Guardian in Scotland or the Mental Health Welfare Commission for Scotland for any information about the number of Makaton users and the level of demand for the interpreters.
Okay. Yep.
And the other thing was to write to the Scottish Courts and the Tribunal Service and Police Scotland to understand how many requests they have received for the provision of Makaton interpreters as well. So just a little bit more exploring, like everybody else has been saying, but yeah. Do keep the petition open.
Okay, that's good. And I think Karen did mention us maybe linking in with the Education Committee as well about that kind of wider, you know, Makaton's an amazing tool for those folk who don't have any other means of communication. And I guess there's a question whether the maximum number of people who could benefit from that means of communication are able to access Makaton in the first place. So I think the committee is unanimous on the view that we should keep the petition open for now, but maybe widen our work in this area, writing to the commissioner and the Scottish Courts and Tribunal Service and Police Scotland, COSLA, the Public Health Guardian and Mental Wealth, and maybe have a chat with our colleagues on the Education Committee as well about what further work we can do. So we'll develop this going forward. But for now, we will be keeping the petition open. So thanks very much to everybody. And again, thanks so much to Sandra for bringing this very specific area, but also the wider area of Makaton in general, to the attention of the committee. That then, therefore, concludes the public part of our meeting. And we'll now move into private session to consider our work programme.